Well, good morning, Encounter Church. Did everybody have a good Christmas? Hey, I know we got some of you have to get rid of some of that sluggish holidayness, but hey, we're going to worship God this morning. Isn't that right? Let's open up our time in prayer. Father, we just thank you for today. God, we're celebrating your birth, of course, with Christmas. And Father, this morning, we're going to enter your gates with thanksgiving and your courts with praise. And so, Father, today, we just invite you into this worship time. We invite you into our praise. And Father, we just thank you that, God, you're still a God that meets needs today. And we thank you, Father, for today in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Let's worship God with amazing grace.
Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who slain. Yes, He is. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who slain. love you, Lord. We worship you today. We adore you today. Thank you, Jesus.
We adore you, Jesus.
Thank you.
sing, oh come, oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let us adore him, Christ the
You're more real than the ground I'm standing on. You're more real than the wind in my lungs. And you're more ground I'm standing on. And you're more real than the wind in my lungs. Your thoughts define me, you're inside me. You're my reality.
Oh,
and I belong to you.
Mm-hmm.
Your thoughts define me. You're inside me. You're my reality. It's only you, only you. It's only you. Number.
Nothing else matters. We belong to Jesus. We are sons and daughters of the King, the great high priest. He sacrificed his life for us, who came as a baby to love on his children. So Jesus, we rest today as your children. Father God, we sit at your feet today, just in awe of you, awe of all you've done this year. Forward to 22, just knowing that we belong. That's all we have to know. That's all we have to cling to, that we belong to Jesus. Fear doesn't exist in the arms of the King. Sadness and pain don't exist in the arms of the King. So Jesus, we run to you. Daddy, we run to you. We lift up our arms and we reach up in faith. Oh, you're beautiful, Father. Sing it one more time, Abba.
Abba.
Every voice in this room today.
Abba, I belong to you.
We belong, we belong, we belong, we belong.
Oh, we belong, we belong, we belong to you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
So we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you only.
Just begin to pour out your praise in your own way. Just begin to tell your Father, God, we love you. We honor you. God, we worship you. This is December 26, 2021. Another service opportunity, God, for us to come together in the name of Jesus and to join our faith for one another. God, we pray that there is an outpouring of encouragement. Someone handed me a word they felt like the Holy Spirit really wants to let us know that God sees, He cares, and He loves. He loves us. Father, I thank you. I thank you that you're beginning just to mend broken hearts, to minister to those who are weary, to bring strength, God, to those who have found that their own strength is failing, God, to move our minds off of our problems and onto your promises. Holy Spirit, I pray that there are supernatural just touches from you that are falling upon people here on this Sunday morning after Christmas 2021, that good things are happening in families and in lives. For those who are online, we lift them up, God. We pray for them. We pray for our brothers and sisters who are watching wherever they are at, God. And we stand with them. We stand with them. We visualize ourselves reaching out and hugging them, reaching out and grabbing their hands and praying one another for one another. We thank you, God, for this. I just want to pray a particular prayer for people who lost something this Christmas. You may or may not know, several of our family members experienced the loss of a loved one over the holiday. We're praying with them and ministering with them, but to others, you know, this was a new year for all kinds of different changes. Some people's travel plans got canceled and they couldn't be with loved ones the way they wanted. But God, we pray that in every family you are present if there is a believer there. God, that the believing person brings the grace of God and the presence of God into these family situations. We see hearts being turned back to you this holiday. We see people beginning to remember that, you know, God said that He would do this. God said that if I was in need, that I needn't be anxious or afraid, but I could come boldly into the presence and lift up my needs to Him. And I thank you, God, for what you're doing. I thank you, God, for what you're doing. You know, last night I did something I never do on Christmas. Usually, you know, we hang out, but we got our stuff done. We had a wonderful, wonderful holiday. But last night I was watching the football game and it got boring. So I went to Christian television and I began, and Marilyn, Charles Capps was teaching. And how many of you ever remember Charles Capps? Anybody, you guys know I do, I'm talking. Charles passed in 2014 and at his ministry is continuing. And he was just talking about speaking the word and talking about, you know, living in a place of faith and not a place of fear. And I really felt like that was not a random moment for me and that God really wanted me to share that with you. That wherever you're at, speak faith, speak life. Let your thoughts be thoughts of good. Let your thoughts be thoughts of God's promises. Put your faith not in what the situations say, but what the word says, what the promises of God are. And so I just want to pray that into your lives and into that. God, I thank you that we are making a decision this Sunday morning to speak faith over our futures, to speak faith over our health, to speak faith over our families, to speak faith over our finances, to speak faith over our government, to speak faith over all the things that make us crazy, God, but in Jesus' name, we don't have to be crazy. We can be in faith, and we speak faith about everything that concerns us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Well, welcome to Encounter Church on the first Sunday after Christmas. Did you guys get really cool gifts for Christmas? Can I show you? My wife got me this Sarah, I can give her a name. She got me this new Fitbit. It's really nice. Give it up for Sarah. But it doesn't count any more steps than the old one did. And I was kind of hoping this would count two steps for every step, but it doesn't seem to do that. Anyway, welcome to church. You may be seated if you didn't. Thank you, people, for helping out. Excited to be with you. Want to make, if the youth are dismissed and let them go. We had a, you guys can go meet Pastor Steve and whatever he's got going on. Am I in the way? I am in the way. Thank you. You're never in the way, Devin. That's Devin. Give it up for Devin. Yay! Devin keeps the wheels on the bus so they go round and round. It's all good. You know, where was I at? I had something brilliant to say. I was going to say, we had a wonderful Christmas Eve service. And for those of you who could be with us, I pray that you and your family were blessed. If you weren't here, I encourage you to watch it online. I thought it was great. The kids were amazing. We had all the kids up here. This one little girl was so fun. She said, I've got a cat. And I asked him, oh, but it doesn't purr. And somebody said, that's because it's a dog. And I thought, no, it was not a dog. I just thought it was so cute. I don't know if you heard it. I just thought, that's cute. I just think that's. Anyway, but God bless you all. You know, this is the time when we also receive our tithes and offerings. This will be the last Sunday that you can sow into 2021. I thank you all who are making those end-of-year gifts to help us kind of reach our goal for the year, and we appreciate those last-minute gifts. They are truly appreciated, and they're truly a blessing. I just believe that where we sow, we reap, and I believe that we shouldn't believe to reap little. We should believe to reap lots. Amen? And so we're planting the seed. Why would we expect small harvests? Let's plant the seeds and expect big harvests in Jesus' name. But if you do want to give and have credit, and they need to be online, they can give online. The e-checks that you do from your bank accounts may not get processed if they're done after probably Tuesday. So if you want to receive credit for giving, the best way to do that this year is either to give by text to give or right now in the services or on the website before the end of the year, because after that it will go into 2022. Did I explain that correctly, Diane? All right, thank you. Go ahead and prepare your offerings. You know, you can text to give by sending the word encounter to 28950. We thank you for continuing to sow. God, I just pray for every tithe, every missionary gift, every seed of faith that's being sown here, Father, this morning. And I just thank you that there's no needs that are beyond you. There's no needs that are beyond you, that you abundantly supply our needs according to the resources of heaven. Not according to our bank accounts, not according to our 401ks or our IRAs. Father, you supply our needs according to the abundance of heaven. And I speak abundance over the Encounter family and over all those who are watching right now. And I thank you that you are good and a generous and a God who it delights you, Father God, to see your children blessed. And I am truly grateful personally and as the pastor of this flock, God, we are grateful for your abundance in our lives. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. You can come forward and drop those off. A couple of announcements I want to share with you. This Wednesday, we will not be having our normal space and place. We're taking a break for the end of the year. However, we have a special guest speaker on our Encounter Wednesday Night Encouragement. You need to tune it in. His name is Kerry Reddedahl. He's a former pastor, church planter, an amazing man of God. And it's a great message, so you want to be there. I do want to let you know that on Friday night from 6 to 7, and you'll see in the pews or in the chairs, you'll see these little prayer cards, and actually they're not so little. We are making a decision to set the tone for 2022 on the last day of 2021, and we do that by taking time to pray into 2022. If you don't expect much, what do you get? Not much, but if you expect a lot, what do you get? A lot. I was talking to somebody one time about miracles, and he said, does every prayer you ever pray get answered? And I said, well, they all get answered, but they're not always answered the way I want. Not every person I pray for experiences the miracle we're believing for. However, people who believe for miracles see way more miracles than people who don't. And that's just a fact, guys. They've proven that time and time and time again. So let's believe the promises and join us that night. It will be streamed, but we encourage you to be here live if you can. At a minimum, please leave us your prayer requests as we get into 2022. We also want to let you know that on January 5th, which is the first Wednesday of 2022, we are kicking off our 21 days of spiritual emphasis, 21 days of connecting with God. It's going to start out with us worshiping God, because we enter his gates with thanksgiving. We enter his courts with praise. And so we're going to start our 21 days of focus. You know, some people will be fasting. We'll be talking more about that next week. But we're going to start on a Wednesday night right here worshiping God. So that's the beginning, and we encourage you to be a part of that. We do have some additional announcements, but for those, please turn your attentions to the big screens.
Hey, Encounter family. My name is Nikki Marshinsky, and I'm super excited to announce that this January, I will be hosting Financial Peace University. Money can be a struggle when you feel overwhelmed and don't have a plan for your finances. This 9-week course from Dave Ramsey will help provide you with practical tools you need to handle money God's way and to feel confident in your financial future. Class begins Monday, January 10th at 6 p.m. in the Fellowship Hall and will run for 9 weeks. To sign up, you can scan the QR code on the screen with your phone, visit the link at ecdenver.org, or sign up at the Information Center after service. I'm super excited to share my story with you all and help you achieve breakthrough in your financial future. See you on January 10th.
Encounter Church, we want to invite you to celebrate with us at our Missions Fair, January 9th, during both services outside of the Worship Center. We will be honoring and supporting our 26 missionaries with food, fun, and prizes. There will be snacks from around the world to taste, as well as the opportunity to win a special prize. Participate in the festivities by wearing your international garb. For more information, go to ecdenver.org/missions.
Good morning. I just gave up my gum. Anyway, that's a blessing to you, as long as I had it. It's delightful to be here. And it's really delightful for me to think of the good things God has done, you know, because I'm probably the oldest person here. And I think I have the most answers to prayer. So put your hand on your heart. You say, oh, I knew you'd do this. Say, I believe. This coming year is going to be my most supernatural. Amen. And I'll tell you how to have your most supernatural. Your most supernatural comes from speaking the promises of His Word. Because it's His Word that brings the supernatural. So I started this very young, speaking promises. And I'm telling you, I got to move mountains and I got what was on the other side. So put your hand on your heart. Say, I believe. I'm going to get what's on the other side of the mountains. Because I speak His promises. And promises move mountains. And I can tell you that's true. And I'm older than you, so I'm smarter. Okay, so I want to look at the names of God with you. Because, you know, looking at these names and encountering them is really something. So one of the names, and I have it down here, is Jehovah Rohi. Say, Jehovah Rohi. Now put your hand on your heart. Say, I will never forget Jehovah Rohi. Now, who is He? Is the Lord my shepherd. So if I can look forward to the new year, then He is my shepherd. He's going to shepherd me through it. And Psalms 23:1 says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Now, no question, David said this, and you can go through his life, and he did not want. You can go through my life saying and speaking the word, and I can say I have not wanted. So am I blessed? Am I God's pet? Say, that's disgusting. Okay. Now, so I looked at this, Rohi, he is my shepherd. That really helps me every morning when I get up, but so does the coffee. I drink coffee with lots of cream, no sugar, and the promises of God. And the promises of God move the mountains of God, and I get what's on the other side. So you say, well, you're so old, but I'm still receiving. And so, you know, I got to go to Saudi Arabia. You say, really? Yes, and I got to do a lot of things because they beat women, but they love old women. And so I'm old. They liked me. And I want to go back, and I want to do some special things there because they are really very open to healing. So the second thing I want you to see, he is your shepherd. He will guide you this coming year. That is so wonderful. But you're going to need provision. We all do, right? So you may need a job. You may need, how many of you here need a job? Would you stand up? If you need a job, just stand up. Okay, everybody's cool. So we don't have to pray for that. Okay. So we need bills paid off. Did I miss anybody?
No, you're good. No,
I got everybody.
It could be people online who need a job. You might want to pray.
Okay, on those online, of course. So we're going to believe for jobs. I think you should stand up. You're kind of lazy this morning. Just get up. It's good for you. Okay, say, I believe for these who need jobs, not to get just any job, but the best job they've ever had. They have the most favor. They do the best. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, you can be seated. You're doing well. You're quite awake this morning, I think. You're excellent. So the Lord is my shepherd. But then he said, I shall not want. So I think speaking those promises is very, very, very important. And I know when I've wanted to do big meetings overseas, they're expensive as crazy, you know. And God has never failed me. And sometimes it's last minute. I don't like last minute. But last minute is better than no minute, right? So don't give up. So it's last minute. So then I want you to see that you can have a job. You can have your bills paid, your debts paid off, because you have Jehovah Jireh. You need a better living situation. You need a new car. You know, I have really had great faith for cars. How many of you need a car? Nobody? Oh, I see. Okay, stand up if you need a car. Good, good. Okay, join hands with the person beside you. Say, thank God.
Thank God.
He's providing. Good cars.
Good cars,
not junk.
Not
good cars. Best cars they've ever had in Jesus' name. And so we see the Lord is our provider. Oh, man, do I ever know that? And, you know, I think people will tell you, well, it doesn't work. You know, too late to say that to me. I'm older than they are. And I've believed for literally millions of dollars to come in to cover the earth with the word. And I can't say that I had a lot of encouraging words. Because I had people who said to me when I got involved with the word, well, of all the pastor's wives we know, you're the poorest example. You don't play the piano. You don't play the organ. You don't sing. All you do is teach those silly little home Bible studies. And those silly little home Bible studies put me around the world. Oh, what can God do in your new year? When you do his word and you believe his word. Now, it says here, Jehovah Jireh means the Lord my provider. And Abraham, and we like Abraham, he's a man of faith. He said that, and he said in this mount it shall be provided. He even named the circumstance. Could I name the circumstance of where I want the money? Could you? Well, then stand up. You're kind of lazy, aren't you? You need to drink more coffee. Right, okay. So I want you to say, Father, You know the circumstance that you're going to meet my needs. You're going to provide. And I believe and I receive in Jesus' name. So, you know, we have so many examples of faith. And I choose those examples. Now, you always have relatives who say it's not going to happen. But now all mine are dead. And I'm still here. And it has happened. Amen. So I think it's wonderful. And now I have found that God has a process. And this is where many people miss it. They miss the process. And so you keep speaking the promises while you're waiting for the provision. So you get up in the morning. I get up in the morning. I make coffee. That helps me. I began to speak the promises. I'm more than a conqueror. I'm surrounded with favor like a shield. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So if you get up in the morning and you speak your groans, I don't know if you want to inherit groans. I haven't noticed they're very good. But if you speak the promises, you can get what's on the other side of the mountain. And if you don't, honey, it ain't going to work. Well, it's just so bad, and I don't feel well, and I don't know what's going to happen. Well, I know what's going to happen, something bad. But if you speak what God says, I also know what's going to happen. So stand up. Oh, so you always make us exercise. It is so good for you. Turn around. Say, this year is a big turnaround year. It's happening. Amen. Now, if I look at something that I really, really want to claim for you, it's number 3. Are you sick in your body? Are you struggling with pain of any kind? Because he carried our griefs, our sorrows, but he also carried our pains. So, as my days are, so shall my strength be. Do I want to go back to Saudi Arabia? Of course I do. Am I going to go? Of course I am. Do they like old women? Oh, they love me. And so if you start speaking those things, well, I'm old and nobody likes me, shut up. Don't do that. Speak the promises of God. It's God's word that works. Now, Jehovah Rapha is your healer, but it also means your health. So I speak this for memory, because sometimes I don't remember things well. And I think, no way, I have the mind of Christ. Jesus has made unto me wisdom, righteousness, sanctification, and redemption. I speak what he says I have in him. The secret is in him. Now put your hand on your heart. Say, I won't forget. Speaking the promises, I'm speaking his word, his will, in Jesus' name, amen. Now, I look at when the Israelites, and I put this in here, Jehovah Rapha, the Lord who heals, they're walking, and they're 3 days without water, and they cried out to God, and they whined a lot. You know, they really did. Do you whine?
No, never.
Put your hand on your heart. Say, whining is not for this year. I'm not planning to whine. I'm planning to speak promises, to move mountains, and get what's on the other side. Amen. Now, they're 3 days without water, and they cry out to God. And when they cried out to God, God gave the answer. Now, you say, well, I'm older. So you're not as old as I am. God still answers my prayers. It's not my age. It's my faith. Yeah. And if you don't, I'm going to get ugly. If you don't read the Bible, how are you going to have faith? So hold your phone up or your Bible. Say, this Bible is very important only if I read it. Now, I mark mine up, so I put question marks in it. You say, oh, you mark up the Bible? Well, let me tell you, it's the words that are holy. And so it's not wrong to mark up question marks. Why on earth did God put this in here? I don't know what he means. So I believe the Bible is your working tool for this year. And without it, you're not going to see the miracles you'd like to see. So look at someone on your right. Say, honey, read your Bible this year. Look at someone on your left. Say, honey, read your Bible this year. Very important. And so I think as we read our Bible, what I love about the Bible, it's so alive, it reads me. And it helps me because people call me with crazy prayer requests, you know, and I can use the Word of God with them. And they think I'm old, so they think I know something. It's really wonderful. Okay. Now, when we see that God wants us healed and whole, we don't have to walk into 2022 sick and out of it. So, you say, well, I have debts. I have all kinds of things. Okay, stand up again. It's good for you. Just don't get nervous. Say, Father, fill my hands with your goodness this year. I receive it. I receive it. It's happening. I'm in the best church in the world because I'm in a faith church. Amen. And so you can be seated. So this is very important to us. He is Jehovah Rapha who heals, but he's also Jehovah Rapha, our health. And we have the mind of Christ. Jesus has made unto us wisdom, righteousness, sanctification, and redemption. What are we saying every day? What do we do? Do you like coffee? I love coffee. But I think coffee is best with the promises of God. And so I drink coffee with promises in the morning because I know God can do all kinds of things. Now, let me tell you, you always have people who tell you things are impossible. You know, when I wanted to have a child, they told me it's impossible. But Wally and I had too much faith teaching to listen to them. And I got pregnant, and I went to a doctor, and the doctor said, you're not pregnant. It's impossible for you. But Sarah, would you stand up? You're still here. The impossibility. Amen! That's why I love faith teaching. And I think we can pass it on. Don't pass on, oh, I have so much pain. I have arthritis. Well, give your arthritis to God and quit talking pain. Talk gain. So these are wonderful names that we can have. Jehovah Tsidkenu, the Lord who is righteous. Now, have you ever done stupid things? Don't raise your hand. Because if you didn't, you're lying. You know, you've just done stupid things. And I did stupid things, especially in college. It just seems like, I just went and had fun the first year, and then I had to work hard the second year because I wanted to graduate, and I had to get with it. So, yeah, we've all done stupid things, but does God forgive stupid people? Does God make you wise in some of your messes? And, you know, I think, how could you overlook some of that? But he overlooks it because he loves you. We have right standing with God because we're the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. That is so key. So if I can say that in the morning, I'm the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, I speak those promises, then I expect the good things. So if you get up in the morning and say, I'm always blowing it, I made a mess, I'll make another mess today, shut up. You're not going to make a mess today. You're going to make a promise. You're going to move a mountain. You're going to get what's on the other side. And you say, well, I'm too old to believe for that. You're not as old as I am, and I'm believing for it. So I'm believing for some big things that I haven't seen yet, but I will. Do you believe me? You don't look like it. Say, I believe you.
I believe you.
Good. Okay. And I love this in Jeremiah 23, 5 through 6. Behold, the days are coming that I will raise to David a branch of righteousness. A king shall reign and prosper and execute judgment and righteousness in the earth. In his days, Judah will be saved and Israel will dwell safely. Now this is his name by which he shall be called, the Lord our righteousness. Oh, I can keep saying that again and again because I think of some of the stupid things I've said, some of the stupid things I've done, and the devil wants me to think about them. But if I can think about his righteousness, amen, that's a whole different ballgame. That's what you want to do. Now, I believe that God is going to give us victory in this coming year. I'm believing this coming year is going to be the best year. And I know you're looking at politics and all those things, but I'm looking at God. God is bigger than politics. Put your hand on your heart. Say, I won't forget. God is bigger than politics. And so I love this, that I can believe God for things that are very special for this year. Now, you may think, well, I've blown it this year. I don't know if I can believe for special. But God forgives. So I want you to pray. You say again, again, and say, I believe God has forgiven me. I have repented. I believe God is making new miracles for me. This year, I believe I have favor this year like I've never had before. I believe this year I have prosperity. I pray for the leadership of our nation that you take their hearts and turn them the way they should go. Thank you, God, that you bless America and you bless me. I'm an American in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Now, could you smile? You know, I know you, some of you have something over your mouth. But you could put it down and smile. And so just smile. And then I want you to know that this coming year is going to be the best. Maybe you're here. And yes, you've known Jesus, no question. But your lifestyle hasn't been so good. This is a good time to just repent and get a new beginning. I love new beginnings. You know, sometimes I just want to slap people. And I don't think God wants me going around slapping people. And I have to repent. Repent of slapping that I didn't get to do. So I'm going to ask all of you to stand up again. It's so good for you. Say, this morning, I repent of holding grudges, being against people that have hurt me. I'm not going to carry grudges. God, fill my heart with love for people. And I thank you today. You're creating all kinds of new beginnings, all kinds of favor in all kinds of situations. And I'm looking to you for the new year. It's going to be my best. Amen. So this morning, I want you just to bow your head for a moment again. How many of you feel, and nobody's going to look around except me, and I'm not mouthy, but how many of you would say, I've kind of blown it this year, and I want to repent? Would you put your hand up? I see that. I see that. I see that. Okay, we're all going to pray. Say, Father, I repent of junk in my life this past year. Father, I know how you are. You're creating a new beginning. And I thank you for that, because new beginnings out of your creation are awesome. So this morning, I take as a new beginning, new beginning. And so I'm going to say bye to my past. Now put your hands up again. Say bye-bye past. Hello. New beginnings. Thank you, Father. This coming year is the very best, and I plan to share it with others in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So, Pastor, would you like to come? Don't you look nice?
I got to tell you, Christmas Eve, I actually had a jacket and tie on. I thought I looked pretty good. I mean, I thought pretty good. So I got up this morning. I said, I'll throw a coat on, but not the tie. Not the tie. I don't want to get too wild. Thank you for sharing, Marilyn. Give it up for Mrs. Hickey. God bless her. She is a treasure. I want to just encourage you before you leave to take just a minute and just fill out that prayer request. And we'll have ushers at the doors or also outside. And please leave an expectation for 2022. If you don't expect much, you don't receive much. I heard that from a very wise person. And I just believe that God wants us to believe that he is bigger than any problem. I mean, seriously, if you need a better paying job, believe for a better paying job. Can I say about your... So, Demetrius, stand up. Okay, can you come up here for a second? This is my friend Dee. We've been friends forever, it seems like, man. But this year... Out of the blue, God, you know, you've been maybe once in a while it was a complaint, but there was a grace, you know, because the job, you know, I like the job, but it's just not what it was. And out of the blue, somebody called you, and what happened in your job?
So I was working in Loveland, Colorado. I live in Lakewood. Hour commute, not the most effective pay, and interviewed for a job in July. They said, not at the moment. And then one of my friends who I've worked with for 10 years became the director of engineers in October. He calls me up and said, this is a formality. We're bringing you on. And I got a 33% increase in pay. I got to work downtown instead of driving all the way to Loveland. I got my parking paid for and a phone allowance. So,
but he's part of our men of purpose, and he got a bunch of brothers in Christ to stand with you. And if you can't believe for yourself, put it down on paper and let us believe with you. Amen. Thank you, Dee. Appreciate it, man. God is good. May the Lord bless and keep you. May he cause his face to shine upon you. May you walk in the revelation of his love, and may you see clearly the steps that he has ordained for you to walk in, that you may experience the fullness of what it means to be a faith-filled follower of Christ. Have a great evening. Have a great day. Have a great 2022. And we will see you Friday night, 6 o'clock, right here. Go with God.